我们想要这样的东西，但是呢，我们的现在的生活已经不是过去那种生活了。
I think this is the next stage of advancement of modern Chinese life.
The reconstruction with minimal intervention in the antique houses is important. You respect what is old, but you do it, the intervention in a contemporary manner, in order to make them livable in today's world.
没有人住的话呢，是毁坏的速度是最快的。如何让人去使用它，这个是一个难题，
它是应该赋予新的生命之后一直走下去。大树活了上千年，宅子也立了几百年，不应该让它在我们这一代人当中毁掉，然后让我们的子子孙孙也继续能看到它。
45 minutes southwest of downtown Shanghai, an anomaly of time exists. Here, centuries-old stone and wood structures stand in harmony with ancient camphor trees, hiding within the luxurious comforts of our 21st century. But how did this blend of tradition and modernity come to be?
When you work on a project for a long time, when you start drawing it, conceptualizing it, it's always special to actually see it complete, to see it being lived in.
All the residences have been arranged along the main avenue. These streets lead you to a cul-de-sac, which is your arrival point for a cluster of four, sometimes six villas.
When designing the furniture, the artwork, down to a light fitting that you see. But they're almost designed as temporary occupants of these old heritage houses. It's the story and the ambition of the project, which is really inspiring.
This excellent traditional wood structure can be transformed into a hotel.是一个难题，就是中国的传统建筑呢，它是木构，它是比较简单的一个维护结构。如果说做一个博物馆，相对来说呢比较简单一点，因为博物馆人们是在这当中是短时间停留，如果是作为一个长期居住或者是旅馆，它就要考虑它的舒适度要求更高。这个其实是一个很难的课题。
The journey to unravel this dilemma began over a decade ago with the rescue of crumbling architectural heritage from China's Ming and Qing dynasties. But are the secrets hidden within these fragments still relevant today?
This space是有序列的，这种序列呢，其实体现了中国传统上的一种礼制。我们想要这样的东西，但是呢，我们的现在生活已经不是过去那种生活了。
To the south of China, in Fuzhou, Jiangxi province, remnants of this architectural heritage are now being left to decay.
At the end of the day, it's a case of either knocking them down and forgetting about that part of history. The other is, let's retain the heritage, but let's be true to it as much as we can. But quite obviously, people don't live that way today, and so there has to be some adaptation to contemporary or modern living.
Surprises, because it only put light on me.
But some argue that to alter the form of these heritage buildings is to disregard tradition.
That's not humanly practical. Okay, people have seen, for example, the beautiful houses, but then people say, oh, they should never tear these houses down, and they should keep all those people living in them. Well, those people, you know, they have to take the night soil and bring it in a bucket down to the river in the evenings or in the mornings, right? That's not a way that most people like to live. So it's all very romantic to say, oh, keep it like that and keep them living there. But if you had to do it, you wouldn't like it.
Can a solution be found by playing with the spaces within the buildings?
这其实是为我们建造搭建的一个一比一的模型。从这边进来呢，这边就是一个正厅，而且这些雕梁画栋其实都是原本的东西。接下来这边是室内的空间。 我们在这边跟传统的不一样，把这边分隔成两个大的卧室。过去是这边是分成好几间的，而且旁边还有仓库啊，其他的功能。Most
important, what we have done is to follow principles that exist in most parts of the world. When you're dealing with old buildings, you respect what is old. But with any intervention, you do it in a contemporary manner. You don't attempt to rebuild the old. In other words, we don't replicate.
But the heritage behind the houses is interweaved with another important element of the Chinese realm.
好不容易来啊，很远啊，是江西那个抚州一个大型准备做个大水库，是延期的那个树，怕是延掉，我们把它救来啊。这个树叫做樟树，樟树有很多种力，这是相当，所以味道那种铜质啊，怕它。
The fact that these camphor trees still stand is because of a rescue operation that began over 16 years ago. But for the man who sparked the original mission, his vision goes beyond just nostalgia.
<音>创新的话呢，其实这个有的时候很难，但也很容易。难呢，在于这个你要做对就行。比如说我们这对的话呢，以前的话呢，我们都知道都是面朝着放的，放在门口。古人都是用在辟邪镇宅。但很多人的话呢，这是习惯性思维，就是传统啊，它就应该是这样啊，它好像就应该是这样。 那我其实它可以转换的，它的美就在于它的尾巴，它尾巴的形态已经是非常非常有艺术感。我就觉得就是我们可以不断的尝试，通过不断的尝试来发现，它美在哪里，然后呢让现代人感到舒服就好了。那么整个这个项目的话呢，也是在所有的节点上都是追求这种以人为本。
But changing the way people regard tradition can be a challenging task.
两个手，体温热啊，往里去拿刀，往里去拿刀，对，好，采取，进去了。对，你领导还有东西，这个普遍，因为这个还能这个党的政策比较好，那个农村都要那个建新村。对，你领导还有东西。
其实的话呢，你看起来很古、很老的建筑，很旧的建筑，它不是不美，只是呢，人们没有注意到它的美。因为这个城市的变迁，这个经济的发展，经济结构的转型，整个社会发现了整个大的变迁。很多这个人呢，从农村进入了城市，那么很多房子呢就遗弃在那里。
改革开放从邓小平之后，啊，很多的那个中国人民的一个从首先在思想上，啊，那种束缚已经没有了，所以说他们很多就下海经商。
Located in Fujiao, Jiangxi Province, is a village that stood for over four centuries.It was once home for officials and scholars of the Ming and Qing dynasties. But the heritage houses that still remain also bear the marks of recent history.
This 门坊的话，它是我们江南地区的典型的这个叫两柱五檐式这个门坊。你可以看到它有些雕刻，它有些雕刻的话，那是60年代的时候被人为的一些毁坏，所以说有些残破。
These scars may mark the toll of history, but our modern times present more threats to this architectural heritage.
其实我们现在，我觉得今年跑得这么快，应该停下来反思一下，就是我们能不能，不要一味的去追求快，能不能追求它久，追求它这个存续的时间更久更美。古代的人都是盖一个房子，要一直流传下去，为子孙盖一个房子，那反倒是我们近现代盖的房子都不见了，都在拆。最缺乏的是一种盖的时候就要有的那个出发心。
But is there a way to repurpose tradition into something relevant for our modern times?
China is about 700 kilometers to the southwest of Shanghai. I've always thought of architecture as being filtered through a sieve of.Traditional values, but still building with a sense of belonging. Now, there's an old Chinese proverb that I've always enjoyed that says, the future is only the past again, entered through a different gate. In other words, the old informs the future. I think the challenge was simply trying to understand the inherent qualities.That the antique houses possessed, how we could not repurpose them because they still will be used as accommodation to live in, but how we might restructure them with minimum intervention.
But can the very tenets of heritage hold up to the needs of modern life? And where do we start to look if we want to bring the past into the future?
We 木结构呢，都是这么多年都是靠工人师傅，然后传承下来的一个工艺，所以它的这个连接方式都有很大的这个经验性。
然后扫一下，上它是直接顶到，这是我们的。这个地方没有。与现代化的施工来说，它是不容易能够继承的，因此我们需要能够找到一个很好的方法。首先要把它算清楚，如果我们能够算清楚它的承载力以后，那我们就可以在规范中给予一些设计建议。后面钢筋的两个螺母都拧上了吗？ 我们这个古代的传统流传下的这种连接方式，它对现代的建筑有很好的启迪作用。因为我们现代我们可以看到那个，在抗震中，我们用到了一个基础格阵的概念。事实上，已经在2000年前已经实现了这个基础格阵的这个概念。扩展4.8，位移3.9，3.4。
What you had at one point, you had the rejection of everything ancient, and nobody wants that, and I only want chrome and steel and glass and all the modern brands from Europe, etc. But as the country has developed, there's greater national pride today. There is a great desire to respect and to recreate what is unique to the Chinese populace. I think it reflects the feeling that Chinese have.
But is this hunger for tradition simply a romantic yearning for eras long past? Or will it push us to uncover deeper meanings hidden in the very fragments that have survived the passage of time? On the outskirts of Shanghai, pieces of homes that once housed Chinese gentry are being carefully collected and numbered. But what can be made from these relics of time? In this warehouse alone are pieces that make up over 40 antique houses. Some dating back over four centuries.
Mr. Ma's vision. It's pretty remarkable that a man, when he was about 28, decided to disassemble 40 antique houses in a village that was marked for demolition. He packed them up, documented every single piece, and moved them over to a large warehouse in Shanghai.
我个人呢比较喜欢这一幢门坊，因为这个雕刻，你可以看得到非常的精美，栩栩如生。而且我们一看它这个雕刻，就知道它一定是乾隆年间的一个雕刻。我们也翻阅了它的家族史跟族谱，它也确实就是标明了这个门坊的主人就是乾隆年间的一个。
非常就是有个大学士吧，然后您可以通过他这个匾额可以追溯到他的祖先是非常荣耀的。这些建筑的话呢，它见证了我们祖先若干代走到我们这一代，不应该就是这么消亡，它是应该赋予新的生命之后一直走下去。 然后让我们的子子孙孙也继续能看到它。
But how can fragments of a bygone era be relevant to a modern world that is always looking forward? Fuzhou, Jiangxi province, to the south of China, was believed to be home to retiring court officials during China's Ming and Qing dynasties. And quite possibly, they used their knowledge of their times to build exquisite enclaves across the southern countryside. In 2002, to power the region's needs, the area became earmarked for a hydroelectric dam project. But the project would submerge a large swathe of these traditional buildings underwater. The loss, invaluable heritage houses, some dating back five centuries, but unknown to many at that time. One man embarked on a mission that would rescue a number of these antique homes.
Every time I see this short film, my heart is very excited.这么多年过去，我自己都想不到，就是这个事情会花这么长时间。第二呢，当时的话呢，怎么会胆子那么大，能够去做这样的一个事情？看到这些东西，我能看到它的美，看到它的价值。那么，我想呢，无论如何，先把它抢救出来、保护出来再说。未来如何使用，可以有时间去考虑。
But even as progress continues to dismantle the past, there are others attempting to pick up the pieces.
This is 砖块，这个砖块是那个老房子上面的外面贴的那个砖块。这个砖呢、啊、这个砖一百几十年两百来年都有，还有三百年都有。这个砖块的特点就是薄牢固，这个砖块就这样叫做蛋壳砖。我是五十几岁我就干这个，我现在是六十七岁了，我对它的感情很深呐、啊。每一根木头每一根材料好的东西要是它损坏了一点我都非常的痛心呐、啊。因为我是考虑到我们国家里面还能这么些老东西，老东西要把它怎么收藏起来，不要让它损坏。
以从农原来的这个农耕社会向现代社会的发展。那么整个社会发现了整个大的变迁，没有人住的话呢，是毁坏的速度是最快的。房子呢，最好的保护呢，就是要有人使用。如何让人去使用它，这个是一个难题。未来的话呢，哎，人们会发现哦，原来我们家的房子还可以这样使用。其实它可以经过设计再改良，再结合你现代人的生活习惯，可以让它舒适起来，更美起来。
Nearly 500 years ago, in a small part of southern China, imperial scholars retiring from the capital.Were believed to have etched their legacies across the facades of the ancestral homes they built for their families, in the hope that the generations to come would fulfill even greater destinies. But the ages that passed have not been as kind to their aspirations. In 2009, international hospitality company Arman Resorts decided to enter into a partnership with Mr. Ma and his team. Their mission? To rebuild the heritage houses stored within his warehouses and to give second life to these forgotten legacies.
We are using the history of the elements to recreate. Eternity is not existent.我追求的是希望精神可以长久一点。
But how can architecture of an era now gone be shaped into homes for a modern generation?
Reconstruction with minimal intervention in the antique houses is important. You respect what is old, but you do it, the intervention in a contemporary manner, in order to make them livable in today's world.
Well, Mr. Ma, the client from the very beginning, he had put together a very interesting and very capable team of experts and consultants to support the design process. And in consultation with some of these experts, we actually got into the details of each antique house, of how the spaces would be used traditionally, originally. The plan is quite simple, but the spaces are quite complicated, the way they come together.Understanding all of that, integrating services within those volumes, integrating structure as it's required for today's times into those antique houses without changing the character of it and keeping that character original was a challenge.
But the original character of the antique houses is but one facade of the story still hidden within their walls.
它原本是没有的，然后是因为文革时期，老百姓们为了防止这些雕刻、这些图案被破坏，所以说就，比较急中生智的、很智慧性的用那个白灰把它涂抹起来，起到一个保护的作用。当时我们也不清楚，只有在那有一天的时候。那有在搬运的过程当中有一块它可能那个白灰那个位置有点裂缝所以说不小心那个裂缝掉下来了所以我们看到里面惊讶地发现里面有雕刻我们现在今天我们去想象一下它当时的一个心境的话可能也没有那么精准只能说当时他的这他唯一的办法就是把它涂抹起来通过这种办法看起我们看起来其实是很笨的一个办法但是至少他们做过了他们尽力了
Can tradition be reinvented to become a blueprint for the future? And can homes from centuries before be repurposed for a modern generation? The cities of our 21st century possess comforts our ancestors could neverimagine. They connect spaces, people, and technology like never before in history. But these developments have also severed man from a realm he once knew. For millennia, the ancient Chinese have seen themselves as part of the natural cycle that governs the cosmos.It is a spirit that's deeply etched into the Chinese landscape.
中国的园林跟那个西方的园林有点不一样。中国的园林呢，它 它一定都是跟原来的建筑是相辅相成，就是互相是对应的，这个从来就是这样。当这个村子出现一些意外的难以保留的时候，建筑有一个迁徙，当然也存在了，就是有一些多年的、百年的，甚至于这样的这个高大的树，可能也需要一个移植，是吧？这样的情况。
在我们老家的话呢，像这样大的树的话呢，是很少有人敢去动的，因为当地的这些村民都信奉这个树有树神的，也没有人敢去砍伐，他们从小就有一种敬畏之心。这些工人去搬的话呢，当地的村民老百姓都质疑我们，因为那个时候的话呢，大多数人去买这些树的话呢，都从老百姓手上买来，买来之后的话呢，他们就去做根雕，做茶海，拿去做这些用，没有来有人尝试过对这么大的树进行移植移栽。
But why are the trees such an integral part of the heritage behind these antique houses? What do they really symbolize in the Chinese universe?
One of the interesting things about this kind of a project or initiative is it sort of beckons up a sense of asking a pretty simple question, which is, over centuries, have relationships between people and trees as objects in our environment, has that changed? In some ways, there's an answer that basically is no. Unlike, let's say, annual plants you can put in your garden, you can grow old with trees in a way that lets you sort of reckon the years.
But in our modern world of steel and glass, is there still a way to express this ancient Chinese desire for oneness with nature? In Fuzhou, Jiangxi province, to the south of China, centuries-old houses believed to be once home to court officials.Still stand across the countryside. Due to their remote location, these exquisite structures also have large storage spaces for food and supplies, features no longer as important for today's inhabitants. Regardless of our desire to preserve tradition, how realistic is it to hold on to such customs?And is there an urgency to repurpose heritage for our times beyond just conservation?
This 边这个窗户呢，在之前我来过的话，它是非常漂亮的。它现在为什么那个空掉了呢？这一块有点被强人为的，而且是暴力的毁坏掉了。因为他这个村的话，现在这个文物贩子经常会把他们里面一些东西都盗走了，卖出去了。可能在我们整个的那个社会发展的朝向当中，可能也是一个必然的一个阶段吧，一个发展的一个历程。周大伯，你好，你好，你好，又见面了。你好，你好。那个周大伯，你这边的话，那个你祖上是从哪里到这里的？
祖上哪里迁来？那我哎，那种话我就搞不清楚。
大伯，到你这一代的话，已经是第几代了？
但我能那天子，我是二十七代了。
二十七代，还吧？你这边去啊？你祖上这是在这边是住去经商的，还是土著住过的？还有什么情况？
那个是我是看传说过哈，据说是经商为重，但你看人家提供的
太。透过像类似这样的老人家，他虽然没有读过什么书，但是根据他上辈的那些老人，一些口口相授的一些传说， 或者是民间的一些说法的话，会把当时建造这个房子的很多的信息，很多的历史的一些脉络能够带出来，啊，我们从中也能发现很多其实非常有价值的一些线索。
It is the information gleaned from field studies like this that is now helping designers repurpose this architectural heritage for the future.
What's very interesting, particularly on this project, is our scope has been extended to the minute detail, right down to the selection of artworks and accessories. I think we're keeping these traditional structures as they are, so they become center stage. And our intervention is not about minimizing these structures or what they represent. In fact, we're trying to avoid any awkward moment when the old and the new meet.
We have worked hard to enhance the volumes of space that exist within the buildings. We've brought natural daylight in through the roof, which is very unobtrusive. We have studied how to do the same thing through the walls without them being unsightly in any way.
So we've decided, for example, that in all the antique houses, the joinery and other items like fireplaces would be freestanding. So they would not be integrated into the fabric of the traditional house. It's a very clear message to the user, and they understand straight away what is a new intervention and what was the environment we were working with.
But the houses themselves are still not complete without the very trees that once stood beside them.
When we went and saw the trees that had been transplanted to this extraordinary sort of reserve, when we think about transplanting a tree, it might have a diameter in terms of its trunk like this, and that's kind of on the margins of what you want to do. Then ask, what happens when you want to transplant a tree whose diameter is, you know, 4 or 5 or 6 feet across? And I think anyone in the world would say the same thing, it's impossible.
With the replanting of the original trees, the houses are now nearly complete. All that remains are people to breathe life into them once more.
Shanghai is a place where East meets West. It's a place with a lot of new development as well as history. It's a perfect place to have this type of project. It's very difficult to find a place that has Chinese culture and heritage restored to the way it used to be. Gives me a very strong sense of timelessness. This is very important in this modern age. We need to have the combination of what is new, but also our roots in terms of what's been very important historically. For people who want to understand how to preserve history, I think there's a lot to be learned from this project.
I think luxury in some cases is brands from overseas, but they're really not Chinese. I think for Chinese people, seeing something as refined, beautiful, and historically rich, I think it's absolutely extraordinary.
In the pursuit of timelessness, other details have also been added. Instead of tiling the pathways connecting the houses, 15 meters long concrete pillars were hammered vertically into the ground to form these walkways, ensuring they will last for at least a few centuries more.
世间的美好往往都需要足够的时间来打磨才能够形成。我的想的话呢，就是来看看这个 古树旁边的古井，古井旁边的古宅。然后呢，如果有朋友们来，我希望他们能够带几颗这个大树的种子带回去。然后你会发现这个大树极其强大的生命力，以及它强大的 DNA。 你看它立在这里，历尽千辛万苦，如同凤凰涅槃，浴火重生。你看，原来这些古树、古宅、古井，它们就是在一起的，从江西的库区抢救出来，到了这里，仍然相依相伴在这里。但井上的那四个字，也确实非常应景：日月共同。接下来，人因宅而立，宅因人得存，人宅相符，感通天地，无需做太多，美存在久。